dapple, dashing, debonair. Little Tom was a picture of perfection. In his crisply ironed red shirt and black new trousers and a pair of matching shoes, Tom, with a broad smile on his face, would win anybody's heart. Of course, his mother's. The joy at seeing her son so dressed up and ready was evident in her eyes. Together, they were getting ready to go for a party, and Tom looked like a rock star nonetheless. However, half an hour later, if you looked at Tom, you would see that he's a picture of disappointment. Sad, swollen, eyes downcast. A look of unhappiness writ on his forehead. He rushes to his mother's side and mumbles into a sari. He says, "Mama, nobody likes me. I'm so alone. I have no friend." His mother, as you would imagine, goes down on her knees, hugs the child, and kisses him, trying to comfort the child. 10-12 years later, a young man, Tom, in his teenager, using probably fair and handsome, and using fog perhaps, and whatnot, that is available in the market, comes home, rushes into his room, slams the door, throws the bag away, and clutches his hair, unhappily. He's annoyed, grumbling, he cries, "Nobody wanna hang out with me, I'm all alone." Fellow Toastmasters and friends, the topic for my speech today is, it's okay not to live for likes. Liking, or the desire to be liked, appreciated, approved, validated, is not for the young alone. It's an affliction that affects even the oldest. I have an example of Miss Housefly, who works at Inspection and More Incorporated. Miss Housefly expected the world to be in love with her, buzzing around her, and she tries every trick in her bag to win over everybody. Sometimes it takes a toll on her. She ends up being extremely unhappy. You see, the desire to please everybody is not an easy one. But then, we all do it. And shopping chains like Myntra tell us, live for likes. All the market products advise us to be more popular is actually a measure of success. And we buy the mantra, or we give in every time, don't we? Well, this topic or this desire to be popular is something that has not escaped the attention of writers as well. In the famous play, Death of a Salesman, the main character, Willie Loman, brought up his children with just one mantra. To achieve that grand American dream, he said, "Be popular, my children, that's enough. You break the laws, you do whatever, it's okay. As long as you're popular, you're winning." What a sad advice it was. What an unhappy, unfortunate turnout it had. For years later, the play ends on a sad note, where Willie Loman is all alone. He's an estranged father. His family is broken. His sons nowhere successful. Be it fictitious or be it in real life, the desire to be popular, the fear of dislike, haunts us every now and then. We all go through this. Well, not only in literature, as in real life, as I just told you, the desire to be popular is something that's a common threat. Ashton Kutcher, the Hollywood biggie, says very simply, "Your happiness is your responsibility. Take charge of it." If your happiness is your responsibility, I may ask you, why should we give the key to our happiness to anybody else's hands? Why should we spoil this life, which is just like a bubble, as the Nepal earthquake just showed us? Why should we spoil any moment of our life thinking about what others think about us? In fact, if we were just about to love us a little more, we would be making this world a better place, a happier place. Well, friends, I conclude by saying the same. It's okay not to live for likes. It's okay not to give in to the market demand or to look up your Facebook every now and then to see how many likes have I got, who liked my picture and who did not. It's okay not to bother about popularity. It's okay just to be in love with yourself. After all, life begins with you. And if you love yourself the more, the better your life will be. Thank you.